First, I'm just going to introduce Dr. Anna Maria. She's a pediatrician. She also has three kids. And I know that, I can't remember if it was one or a few of your kids had eczema, but I know that you dealt with that and allergies, oh, two of them. And I know you also helped them go through and also overcome ADHD. So you have gone through a lot with your kids.
Yes, I have. Did I tell you that my dog had eczema?
Did
I
tell
you that? The other day, I was like, I'm not sure. Yeah, when my puppy was like 2 years old, he had these weird blotchy things. He's a Rhodesian Ridgeback and he has like this brown coat and they're known for sensitive skin, of course. And he had these black spots as where he lost hair and it was like raised and eczema looking hideous little thingies. And I took him to the vet and they're like, steroids and antibiotics. Okay, the first time, fine. The second time, fine. The third time, I'm like, listen, like he keeps getting these weird spots and they were big and it looks like the mange, really. And they were like, all right, well, if it keeps happening, we'll do a biopsy and just kind of really dig a little deeper into what's going on. He also happened to get ear infections at the same time that these things would appear. And I'm like, So we walked out of there and then that's after I had finished one of my children's healing her eczema. And I looked at my husband, I was like, okay, well, I'm not a vet, I'm a pediatrician, but food has been the root cause for the, you know, one child who had eczema at the time. And I was like, what if that's what's going on with a dog? And he's like, you're so weird with your stuff, you know? And I went home and I Googled, and sure enough, the breed has many issues with their skin and they have food allergies. And I concocted my own concoction of dog food with raw meat and like cooked all these vegetables and whatever. And lo and behold, the dog's skin completely resolved. Okay. Fun fact, he became really constipated because I don't know how to make dog food. But once we saw that, we're like, oh my gosh, the common denominator was we removed grains was one of his big issues. So we removed grains out of his diet. He went on a full raw diet by a vet. and then never had another skin issues ever again in the past 5 years. And his ear infections also happened to resolve.
That's amazing.
I totally forgot the story.
Wow. Thanks for sharing that. I have someone who actually shared about how pets can get topical steroid withdrawal too. And they shared some photos and it looked pretty bad.
I'm sure. I mean, it seems like when I go, they're dogs, they don't go through. No, I think that they have a lot of similar issues. I'm not a vet. I don't pretend to be one. That's my observation.
Well, your dog is really grateful and just lucky to have you because you chose the alternative route where he didn't have to go through all that suffering.
Yeah. And you know, I'm annoyed I didn't take pictures because I mean, he looked horrible. So I didn't want to take pictures of my ugly looking dog. And now I wish I had, so I can like, I was like, look what happened. Cause you know, you probably think that it wasn't that big of a deal. It was terrible.
Wow. Thank you for sharing that. That's, you know, it's always interesting to learn about how pets can be affected that way too.
Right.
Yeah.